question number four, we're given an angle, or the theta, 5 pi over 6, and we're asked to find exact values for these a, b, and c. So cosine squared of theta. So what we can do here is, that's really cosine of 5 pi over 6, and even though they put the square on the cosine, it's the whole thing that is getting squared. So we'll look up cosine of 5 pi over 6, and that's where having our unit circles helpful. 5 pi over 6 is over here, 150 degrees, and the cosine is going to be the x-coordinate, which is negative square root of 3 over 2. Negative square root of 3 over 2. Let's go back here. So this is going to be equal to negative square root of 3 over 2 squared. So it's going to be positive, because when we square this, square root of 3 squared is 3, right? So again, if you want to think of it this way, times negative square root of 3 over 2, we're squaring it, that's going to give us 3 over 4. 2 times 2 is 4, square root of 3 times square root of 3 is 3, negative times a negative is a positive. Three-fourths. And we're going to see similar things happening here. So cosine of 2 theta. So we want cosine of 2 times 5 pi over 6. Now, this is like 2 over 1, so we can do some arithmetic in here. The 2 goes into 6, 3. So this is going to be the same thing as cosine of 5 pi over 3. So that's a different place than 5 pi over 6. And so we go back to our unit circle that we created earlier somewhere. Oh, it's right here. 5 pi over 3. Here's 5 pi over 3 down here. So remember, 5 pi over 6, we talked about this in the review, that when you do 2 theta, you're going to be in a different place. So we were at 5 pi over 6, but 2 theta, we multiply that by 2, we're at 5 pi over 3. And notice it's the x-coordinate of this point here on the unit circle. The x-coordinate is 1 half, if you can see that. So that's what you want to refer to. That's where making this unit circle is going to be helpful for us, 1 half. Was equal to 1/2. And it's always good, you know, as you're doing your scratch paper, I know I'm a little bit messy myself. Most of you are so much better at your scratch work, and it's nice to have them labeled, have your work out here. Remember, at the end, there'll be a place where you can submit your scratch work for partial credit, because if you make some errors in here, we get it wrong, we won't get any points from Alex, but I can then come back and review your scratch work and find correct work that was done with maybe one error. So the last one, so this was A, B, and C. And then so the last one's going to be cosine of the negative 5 pi over 6. So what is that? Again, that's going on the unit circle, but that's going to go backwards now. So it's kind of good that we did count. So we're starting at 0, 0, going back 5 pi over 6, right? So 5 pi over 6. Well, where's 5 pi over 6 on the upside? It's up here. This is 5 pi over 6. So we're going to be in a similar place, but so we went from here to here. That's like 150 degrees. That's, for me, easier to think. So I'm going to go back 150 degrees. So 360 minus 150 gives me 210, right? Because I'm going backwards. So that's 7 pi over 6. That's the location. And so the cosine is the x coordinate, which is negative square root of 3 over 2. Negative, so it's right there. Negative square root of 3 over 2. So yeah, we ended up here. Negative square root of 3 over 2 was the x coordinate. The y coordinate was negative 1/2, but we don't really care. Negative square root of 3 over 2. And so let's put the negative square root of 3 over 2. There we go.